Welcome to Low Country Snapshots. I'm Georgia Lash, sitting in for Margie Bruiser. And today's edition, our guest is Mary Treadwell, a Sun City resident and artist. Pablo Picasso said, "Every child is an artist. The only problem is to remain an artist once we grow up." Mary hasn't had that problem, and in today's show, we'll find out why. Welcome, Mary.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Like Picasso said, every child is an artist. So what are your memories of your early experiences in art?
Probably my first experience is I won first place in the art show for the Archdiocese of Boston. I was probably 7 years old, and my father was just so excited that he signed me up for lessons right away down in Rockport, Massachusetts, which is really an artist community. And, you know, and I painted with a wonderful artist, I don't remember the name, on Saturday mornings. Did that for a long time. So that was my first.
As all children, you progress through school. Mm-hmm. You're taking your private art classes, you're in school, looking at your other subjects. Did you already start to develop a particular love for a medium or perhaps some influences?
Okay, I played with all kinds of mediums, but it wasn't consistent. In high school, I was in an art club, and I know we did a mural on this big wall and did ceramic tiles. And we all did our own thing, and I remember doing pen and ink and contour drawing, and I loved every minute of it. And I really wanted to go into art school after I finished high school.
Now, I understand after high school, though, you did go to the University of Massachusetts.
I did.
Now, I would be betting that you were an art major, but I heard that wasn't the case. What happened?
Well, I wanted to go to art school or major in art, but my mom and dad convinced me that it would be difficult to get a job to make a living afterwards. And then I want to go into nursing. And my mother was a registered nurse, and she said, "You don't want to do that. It's a lot of work and a lot of dirty work, and the doctors aren't really nice to you." And she said, "I think you should be a dietitian. They're down in the kitchen, and they get paid more than the nurses, and they don't work as hard." Which wasn't true, but.
I understand you met your husband in high school, but you've now gotten to college, and you get married after your internships?
Yeah. Well, I met him in high school. I had a job at Russ Treadwell's ice cream store. And I tell people we met over the chocolate chip.
Now, so life begins as a married couple, and your husband has a career which allows some travel, and you have a very enviable move, enviable to me at least, in 1993. Where did you head to?
To Paris. Initially, we were going to London. And I went over to London to find schools for the kids. At that time, my son was 5. And my daughter was 13, and I found schools and a house to live in. I got home that very night. My husband said, "Guess what? We're going to Paris instead. Are you okay with that?"
"Are you okay with that?"
I said, "Sure." And he said, "Now you have to come to Paris and find schools and a place to live." And I said, "No, you're going to have to do that on your own, because I don't think I could get anybody to take care of the kids for another week." So he did, and we went to Paris that following, I think it was in July.
Now, Mary, you're an artist at heart. You're living in Paris. Mm-hmm. How did you begin to navigate the Parisian art world?
Well, I joined the American Women's Group and another club called Weiss, and I don't remember exactly what it stands for. And I took a watercolor class. And I hadn't painted since my son was born. He took all my energy. But now he was in first grade. So, and I took this watercolor class. I said, gee darn, I know more than she does, and I haven't painted in a long time. So I mentioned that to my landlord, Eugenie Anglais. And she was American, married to a retired French ambassador, and also the curator for Blenincourt Museum outside of Paris. And so she had many contacts. She said, I will find you a teacher. And so she talked to everyone, and everyone came back and recommended Chantal Chevenier-Riant.
Now, tell me, with an experience of working with a famous artist, what are some of the highlights that you can remember from that experience?
Okay. She needed to interview me, because she didn't take anybody, just anybody. And so I brought paintings that I had done, and so she could see where I was, where I needed to go. And her comment was, huh, you want compliments, sir?
Please.
I said, no, I just want you know where I am. I remember I had to sign up for 10 classes because she felt that I couldn't learn anything mm-hmm. in less than that. And 10 classes turned into another 10 and another 10, and it was weekly. And I learned so much from her, more about her discussions. What is art? I'd show her something. Huh. Interesting anecdote. It was like, poof. Okay. Or pretty decoration.
Ooh, that hurt.
So I learned a lot with just things like that. She also owned a chateau with her family, with her brothers and sisters, and it was Tanley, Chateau Tanley, that was in the Chablis area. And she invited me out. We became very good friends. And she invited me there for a week to paint with another American artist. And it was like a dream come true. You got up in the morning and you had a baguette and some Nutella or cheese. And then you went out and painted till about 2. And then came back for a big lunch. And then it was siesta time. And then we went back outside and painted from like 4 to 7. And then came back and had a light dinner. And then an after-dinner drink, and then went to bed. And then did it again, day after day.
What a life. Now, your art begins to get noticed in Paris. Mm-hmm. Did you have a chance to do any shows there?
I did 2. And I think they were both after London. One was at the OECD. Actually, Chantal set me up to teach there.
Now, again, explain to us the OECD.
Organization of Economic Development. It was kind of like a big think tank, and from people from all different countries. It was very international, and it was in a chateau, right? In the 16th arrondissement
Now, your role with the OECD, was that strictly as an artist doing a show, or did you also get
no,
into some other
teaching.
Things? I have to ask, as a teacher, how do you teach an art class, you know, to talented artists compared to, let's say, a high school teacher? What was a class like? What would it have been?
Sort of a round table, and everyone worked on their own projects, things that talked to them that they had a connection to. And I would guide each one on their, depending on their level and their subject matter. And that's the way I teach here in Sun City.
We'll talk about that for sure. Now, you were able to not only teach in Paris, but did you also teach in London as well?
I did. We moved to London, and I actually contacted Chantal to find out if she knew anybody I could continue my studies with. And she said, Mary, you just need to paint.
Do you think that teaching helped you as an artist?
Oh, absolutely. When you teach, it reminds you of all the things that you do know.
Do as I do, do as I say. Very good.
You know, all these things that I've learned through the years come up.
Now, you returned to Paris, though, after 6 years in London, I understand.
Yes.
Oh, again, lucky you. Did you continue the art classes again, or
no,
did you continue
no,
the painting and teaching?
We became good friends, and we'd get together and go out and paint, do some plein air painting together.
Oh, on plein air. Oh, beautiful.
And we'd go all over Paris. And that's when I was teaching at the OECD, and I had a show there. And I can remember a good friend, a French friend, there, I got champagne for everyone. And she said, oh, Betty, she said, everybody will come, the champagne. I said, that's the point.
Well, I guess at this point in your life, you're packing up your memories and probably many, many pieces of art, and you head back to the United States. Mm-hmm. Did you get to pick up here with your teaching, with your painting?
Well, we moved from the Republic of France to the Republic of Texas. So we were in Dallas, and I found it very difficult.
You know, having had so much experience internationally, what differences did you perceive with the American artist, the American art student, compared to those international experiences?
Well, one thing that comes to mind, first of all, almost every town in the area of Dallas had an art group, an art club. And I remember signing up to be on a show, to enter a show, and reading the prospectus. The very first line was, no nudes. And that was really, that struck me really funny after coming from Paris.
I could see where I
would go to the live drawing, and they were definitely nude. So that was funny. In Dallas, pretty much all the artists painted in the studio. It was very controlled. And that was because it was either too hot or too cold. And also Dallas was concrete. So there weren't that many places to go. You know, to get something really pretty, you probably need to drive 2 to 3 hours.
All these influences you've had have, you know, certainly contributed to your own body of work. So we need to spend a little time talking about that. Your favorite medium?
Watercolor.
All right. Do you have a favorite piece?
I have many favorite pieces. And I was asked to bring my favorite. This is one of them. King George the 14th, and that was at Versailles. And that was done in plein air. And I had a friend with me that was visiting, an artist friend from Marblehead, Massachusetts, Patty O'Hare Williams, and which we've painted together many places around the world, really. And that was one of my favorite. Another experience I had in France, in Paris, was learning how to mat the paintings differently than you get, that you do here.
It's beautiful. It's beautiful work, and it looks a little more intense.
And it probably took me longer to do the matting than do the painting.
Now, how do you decide? Do you have a favorite subject you like to paint?
I do series of paintings. At times, I was doing a series of fish paintings that I probably did like 20. They're all very vibrant, very colorful. I have one here that I brought that it's blue fish. Then I had a series of frogs where I did probably 10 different frog paintings.
That sounds like fun. It sounds like it gives you a chance to play on each one.
Yeah, and it's amazing. Once you get to know the physiology of a frog or a fish, it gets easier and easier. My favorite paintings are often the story behind them, but more than if they're the best painting technically.
Now, do you still keep in touch of, you know, with any of your friends that were over either in Paris or London here in the country?
And pretty much the expats that were my friends in Paris and London are in the States now. And we get together. I feel like I have best friends from all over the world.
Now, you have landed here in Sun City. Mm-hmm. What brought you here?
I love it here. I asked my husband as soon as he retired that we were leaving Texas. It wasn't my favorite place. It was good to me, though. And so we took a road trip from Texas, and then we went through the Panhandle, down the south and the west coast of Florida, up the east coast of Florida. We knew Florida, and we really didn't want to go to Florida. And then we were headed up to Mount Pleasant in Charleston, and I saw the sign, Hilton Head. I said, I've heard about Hilton Head. It was a good stopping time. And so we went out to Hilton Head and stayed overnight. It was too bad, it poured rain all day. Then on the way back, I said, there's a Del Webb, Sun City, let's just check it out, since that was our goal for this trip. And we got a tour. I just loved everything about it. But we went on, my husband wasn't too keen. He liked it, but he had his heart set on Mount Pleasant. And so we went up to Mount Pleasant, stayed there, and in Charleston, and I loved that too. But then we were looking at houses to build, and they were all in developments that they were beautiful. But I didn't want to be the grandmother of the neighborhood.
So when I ask you what you love about Sun City, one, we're in our own age group, but what else do you love about Sun City?
I love everything. I do water aerobics. I'm involved in the art club, all about art. I'm one of the teachers there.
What a surprise.
I love walking, the ambiance, the scenery. I'm involved in plein air painting. With friends from the art club. My neighborhood is fabulous. We built a new house in a new neighborhood. And so it was like being an expat. No one knew anyone, so everybody wanted to get to know you.
Now, what classes do you teach here?
A watercolor. What a surprise.
Again.
And I teach them on Saturday afternoons from 1:30 to 4. And the deal is you have to sign up for 3 classes. I would love to have said 10.
Oh, I wonder where that came from.
But not many would sign up for 10. But I have some regulars that just keep on coming back, so. And they do their own thing. A lot of the classes at All About Art are a themed class, and everybody paints the same thing. I feel that you need to paint something that talks to you, that means something to you, versus everybody do the same thing, because you're comparing yourself to everybody else and the teacher, and I'm not a fan of that. Although the teachers are wonderful and people learn, it's just different. And I have all different levels, and I always say I love having beginners because I'm always better.
With your body of work, with all the beautiful art experiences you've had, what words of inspiration would you give to somebody who's maybe sitting there saying, I wish I could pick up that paintbrush for the first time. I wish I could pick it up after many years. What would you say to them?
Do it. Do it. We also have a class, of course, COVID times has hurt things, but 2 for $20. It's 2 2-hour classes for $20. And all materials except for paper is provided. So, and they have them for pastel and watercolor, and they're trying to find an oil painter to teach collage, to get an idea of what the medium is all about. And then they could pursue it in a different way. And they might find, no, this isn't for me. A lot of people feel that watercolor isn't, it's not forgiving. Believe me, there's so many ways you can fix it. And I'm not a purist. I will use acrylic. I will use gouache to get it to be the way I want it. You know, I've been told, you do whatever you need to do to get the effect that you want.
Mary, tell us about this piece.
Okay, I did this in studio work in Dallas after I was in Venice. Ooh. And it was from a photograph I had taken of a mask that was, I think it was in a storefront. And I did a whole series. And I used a lot of gold. And I probably enhanced the decorations and threw a little salt on the background to give some texture. And there was some gouache in there. There's some gold paint. And I probably did about 4 or 5 different masks. Okay, this is a recent painting that I did from a photo that I had that I took at the Atlantis Aquarium in Nassau, that the sun was coming down and, you know, and I composed the fish in different directions. This guy wasn't looking at me, but I call this one peekaboo.
That's true, I haven't asked you. Do you normally name your paintings?
I do, calling it Bluefish, but then I decided it's peekaboo.
Much more fun.
And again, this is pretty much exclusively watercolor, and I did use some resist, it's called maskoid, to save some of the whites. And I did go in with white paint, put some bubbles in there. During quarantine, I've been painting a lot, and I've been doing a lot of Paris paintings. And this is one of them that's going up to Montmartre. And anybody that's been in Paris have probably walked up that street where the Place du Tourne is up there, where all the artists congregate and sell their wares and go to the church. And it's a scene that I've always wanted to paint, and I never did. This was a painting that I did with a friend, a plein air painting. She was French, and we were staying at her house that was on an island close to here. This is La Rochelle.
which is a medieval town. And it was just such a beautiful day, and we just painted all day and then took a boat back to the main island.
Mary, I thank you for your time today. I think you've painted a brighter picture for us here at Low Country Snapshots. Thank you so much.